Hydration, heat, and heat-related stress are the topics of the week. Hydration is very important out here in the tropics. One of the key things is to do your exercise either early in the morning or towards the evening. Avoid midday exercise. That's the heat of the day. That's when you're really stressing your system. But even now, it's hot. It's after 5, but the temperature hasn't gone down. And the pavement temperatures here run 45 to 50 Celsius. I've measured them. So on top of this black asphalt, the temperature is much higher than the air temperature, which is probably just under 90. Hydration's important. Carry a water bottle with you. Always. Now I'm a runner. I can't carry a water bottle. So I tuck a dollar in my pocket. And if I need water, I pick it up. If it's a longer run, I might take 2. Heat can strain the body. I've been running for 41 years in the tropics. I'm heat acclimatized. But you, if you're a beginning walker, are not. You are not heat acclimatized. Key thing to watch out for is heat exhaustion. Heat exhaustion is the first stage of heat illness. Heat exhaustion, you're lightheaded, you're dizzy, possibly disoriented. You can feel that you've overheated. If you've gotten used to listening to your body, you can feel it. The dizziness, maybe a sense of nausea. The sense you'll have usually in a sense of deep thirst and weakness. If you think you're experiencing heat exhaustion, you need to get into shade, rest, give yourself some time, get your core temperature down. You'll be able to go again and get to water, but you're going to have to go easy. Because heat exhaustion is the first stage, and if you push through heat exhaustion, you can wind up having heat stroke. Heat stroke is basically where your body shuts down. It's a dangerous condition. Your body no longer has enough fluids to perspire. You cool your body by perspiring, and heat stroke occurs when you've run out of water to shed his sweat. Now, oddly enough, the ability to perspire can be improved by working out in the heat over many years. So I can run longer and farther in the heat than I could 40 years ago. That's why you're starting with walking. Tropics is a tough place to start an exercise routine because of the heat risks involved, especially if you have factors like high blood pressure or other factors that can exacerbate your potential heat issues and that you aren't as healthy as you could be. So this week we'll look at hydration and heat related illness.